Unit 3, 3-1, the plain form or dictionary form of verbs. Again, I'm going to use what the course book refers to as group 1 and group 2 verbs, even though everyone else calls them the other way around. But let's look at putting group 1 verbs into the present affirmative plain form. It's really simple. All we do is drop the mas and replace it with ru. For example, tabemas becomes taberu. Mimas becomes miru. If we want to put a verb into the present negative, then we replace masen with nai. For example, tabemasen becomes tabenai. Mimasen becomes minai. To put it into the past affirmative, it's the same rule as the te form, only that instead of using te, we use ta, or where you would have de, you would use da. So for example, tabete becomes tabeta, mite becomes mita. Or oyoide becomes oyoida. To put a verb into the past negative, we replace the e with katta. So tabenai becomes tabenakatta. Minai becomes minakatta. Group 2, we drop the mas. And in the mas form, all of these verbs have a kana that rhymes with e before the mas. So we drop that. We replace it with a hiragana that rhymes with u. So what we do is that we go one space down in the hiragana order. For example, look at kaimasu. You can see here that in the hiragana order, I goes after a. We have a, I, u, e, o. If we go down one space, we go from I to u. So kaimasu becomes kau. Nomimasu, again we have mamimu memo. So mi goes down to mu, and nomimasu becomes nomu. Norimasu, we have rariru de ro. Ri goes down to ru, and norimasu becomes noru. So to put group 2 verbs into the present negative for plain form, we're going to go in the reverse order on the hiragana chart. So we're going to go up instead of down, and masen will be replaced with nai. So let's look at nomimasen. Mi comes second in the order with mamimu me mo. Instead of going down to mu, we're going to go up to ma. So it becomes noma. Then we replace the masen with nai. So to not drink becomes nomanai. Nomimasen becomes nomanai. Norimasen similarly becomes noranai. Now there is one special exception here, which is verbs that have e before the mas, like in kaimasen. Here we're not going to go up to a, so it does not become kanai. Okay, what happens is that the a becomes replaced with wa. To put group 2 verbs into the plain past tense, we follow the exact same rule as te form, except that where you would have te, it becomes ta, and de would become da. Let's compare a few verbs in its te form versus its plain past affirmative. So for example, omocha o katte, buy a toy. Omocha o katte, bought a toy. Mizu o nonde, drink water. Mizu o nonda, drank water. Jitensha ni notte, ride a bicycle. Jitensha ni notta, rode a bicycle. And so on. To put group 2 verbs into the plain past negative, we follow the same rule that we had before for putting it into the plain negative. However, we drop the e and we now replace it with katta. So for example, kawanai, to not buy, becomes kawanakatta, did not buy. Nomanai becomes nomanakatta. Noranai becomes noranakatta. And so on. Finally, we'll look at the plain form of irregular verbs. The plain form of shimasu is suru. Shimasen becomes shinai. Shimashita becomes shita. And shimasen deshita becomes shinakatta. And you can see two examples I've put here with renshu shimasu and benkyou shimasu. So, for example, renshu shimasu is renshu suru. Renshu shimasen becomes renshu shinai. Renshu shimashita becomes renshu shita. And renshu shimasen deshita becomes renshu shinakatta. With kimasu, this becomes kuru. Kimasen becomes konai. Kimashita is kita. And kimasen deshita is konakatta. Ikimasu becomes iku. Ikimasen becomes ikanai. Ikimashita becomes itta. And ikimasen deshita becomes ikanakatta. Arimasu becomes aru. Arimasen becomes nai. Arimashita becomes atta. And arimasen deshita becomes nakatta. Imasu becomes iru. Imasen becomes inai. Imashita becomes itta. And imasen deshita becomes inakatta. 3-2, expressing hearsay. So the pattern here is to add sordes or sorda after a verb or adjective. And then we add dasordes or dasorda after a noun or descriptive noun only in its affirmative tense. For example, ashitaga furusodes. I hear that it's going to rain tomorrow. Restoran wa betonamu ni yume dasordes. I hear that this restaurant is famous in Vietnam. And so on. 3-3, expressing similarity. The pattern here for the affirmative is to take a verb in its must form, but we drop the must. If it's an adjective, you drop the E, and if it's a descriptive noun, just leave it the way it is, and you add sordes or so if it's in the plain form. For example, 明日 雨が降りそうです. It looks like it's going to rain tomorrow. お母さんのケーキは美味しそうです. Your mum's cake looks delicious. One special exception here is the adjective E. 来週の天気は良さそうです. Next week's weather seems good, so E becomes 良さそう. Expressing similarity in the negative plain form. So the pattern here is to take a verb, adjective, or descriptive noun, and we drop the E and add 良さそう. For example, 明日雨が降らなさそうです. It looks like it's not going to rain tomorrow. お母さんのケーキは美味しくなさそうです. Your mom's cakes don't look delicious. 座標記と平面幾何学は大変じゃなさそう。 Coordinate and plane geometry doesn't seem difficult. Let's compare. 雨が降るそう。 I hear that it will rain. This is something I would say if, for example, someone else told me that it's going to rain. 雨が降りそう。 It looks like it will rain. For instance, if I were to look out the window and I saw big, dark, heavy storm clouds gathering, I would say 雨が降りそう。 雨が降らないそう。I hear that it will not rain. If someone were to tell me that it's not going to rain, this is an expression I would use. 雨が降らなさそう. It looks like it will not rain. If I were to step outside and I saw clear, bright, sunny skies, then I would say 雨が降らなさそう. Take note that the so pattern for verbs can only be used to describe something that hasn't actually happened yet. For example, あの箱から落ちそうです. Looks like he's about to fall off that box. Do not use saw to describe something that is too obvious. For example, when looking at a cute baby, you do not describe it as かわいそう because everyone can see how cute it is.
Great deals on history.
3-4.Sona or Sony, describing what things are like. So to describe nouns, we take any word in its so form because that's so good.
The music's bad and you should feel bad.
We add na and then we add a noun. For example, yasashi so na hito, a person who seems kind. Naki so na kao, a face that looks like it's about to cry.Benli so na tokoro, a place that looks convenient. Describing verbs, soni modifies adjectives to function as adverbs. So the pattern here is to take an adjective in its so form, we add ni, then we put the verb after it. For example, oishi so ni tabeteiru, eating delightfully. Tanoshi so ni hanashiteiru, talking pleasantly. Ureshi so ni waratteiru, laughing happily, or happily laughing.If you choose to split your infinitives, but we can't do that in English.
To boldly go where no one has gone before.
3-5, kara, giving reasons, now in plain form. So as we discussed in Unit 2, we use kara to indicate a reason. We're doing the same thing here, only that we're doing it in plain form. So note, if the sentence ends in polite form, the reason can be provided in either polite or plain.But if the sentence ends in plain form, then the reason must be given in plain form. For example, Yuki-chan wa chiisai kara dekinai. Yuki cannot do it because she's small. Kyō wa mokuyōbi da kara taisōgi o kiteimasu. I'm wearing my PE uniform today because it's Thursday. And so on. 3-6, node, as because or. So here we're using node to also indicate a reason. For example, atsui node mado wo akete kudasai.Please open the window since it's so hot. 今日は木曜日なので体操着を着ています。I'm wearing my PE uniform today because it's Thursday. And so on. So what's the difference between kara and node? In a simplistic sense, the difference may be defined as nor depth, expressing causation and sounding somewhat more objective, whereas kara tends to express reason and sounds more subjective. Kara is preferred when X expresses the speaker's conjecture about something, or Y is command, request, suggestion, or invitation. Examples of when kara is preferred. For example, 人がたくさん来るだろうから食べ物をたくさん買いました。Because many people will probably be coming, I've bought a lot of food. This is a form of conjecture or speculation. もう遅いから早く寝なさい。Go to bed because it's already getting late. I'm giving you a command. あの映画は面白いからどうぞ見てください。Please watch this movie as it's interesting. This is a request. 明日は暇だから一緒にカラオケに行きましょうか。I'm free tomorrow, so shall we go to karaoke together? This is a form of invitation. その映画は面白くないと思うから見たくない。I don't want to watch that movie because it's not interesting. This is my personal opinion. I've also put in a blurb here that explains the origin of where Norde comes from. I'll let you pause this video and read that in your own time. 2-7, using te kara to express after or since. To put something in the te kara form, we simply put the verb in its te form and we add kara. That's it. It's te form with kara becomes te kara. So, for example, 昨日宿題をしてからアニメを見ました。Yesterday I watched cartoons after I did my homework. And so on. So as long as you know your te form, you'll be pretty cool with this. 3-8, saying from to using kara made. So the pattern here is that we take some point in space-time because as science tells us, space and time is the same thing. We then put kara after that to say that we've come from a point in space-time. We then put another point in space-time and put made after it to say that we've gone to our destination in the fabric of space-time. For example, 午後10時半から午前6時まで寝る。I will sleep from 10:30 p.m. to 6 a.m. ここから駅までどのぐらいかかりますか? How long does it take to get from here to the train station? 明治維新から第二次世界大戦までの時代は大日本帝国と呼びました。The period from the Meiji Restoration to World War II was called the Empire of Japan. 3-9, using ga and けれども, now with plain form. So the pattern here is to take a verb in its plain form, an adjective in its plain form, and if it's a descriptive noun or a noun in its plain form, we add da after it, and then we add ga or けれども to express but. But what's the difference? There's no discernible semantic difference between ga and けれども. Both can be used fairly interchangeably. けれども is arguably more formal sounding than ga. However, it's perfectly fine to use ga in polite settings anyway. For example, 申し訳ないんですが, I do apologize, but... So some examples. 僕は何も言わなかったけれども、ジャックはもうしていました。I didn't say anything to him, but Jack already knew it. Pokemon Go は楽しそうけれども、他にもっとすることがあるよ。Pokemon Go looks fun, but I've got better things to do. And that takes us to the end of Unit 3. I'll see you all for the next unit.
宇宙、それは人類に残された最後の開拓地である。そこには人類の想像を絶する新しい文明、新しい生命が待ち受けているに違いない。これは人類最初の試みとして5年間の調査飛行に飛び立った宇宙船 USS エンタープライズ号の脅威に満ちた物語である。こちらエンタープライズ。では乗組員をご紹介しましょう。私がカーク船長です。宇宙人のスポック副船長、我々のドクターマッコイ、ミスター加藤にウラ少尉、チャーリーとジェニー。
Turning some dog poo, mate. Great days of history.